So previously, I explained how we have this data structure. So we've got a table called students, and we've got the courses, and those students are enrolled into courses. So it's a very simple structure. And then we talked about why we have the classes set up here. So for example, student class has student ID and name. And then we've got the collection here to store the student's enrollment. So think of it like a basket where you store how many courses the student enrolled into. That allows you to add, delete any courses the student is enrolled into. But then this setup gives you a very good advantage, which is you can then use a link to query that data. So here you can see that I am going to retrieve a student called John. And here I am using the link where query method. We're going to compare the name of the student against John over here. As soon as we have that, then we have these two weird looking include statements. So then include for courses and include for enrollment. So what do they actually do? So you can see in our class, we have enrollments, which is a type of list you can think of. So it's a collection of enrollments. So what we are doing is for the same student, once we found him, we want to include all the enrollment that the student is on. Then we want to include the actual course name that the student is on. So what this allows you to do is then print out the name of the student, and for each enrollment, so here we are looping through using for each enrollment, we want to go through and print out the course title. So you can see what is happening here. We loop through. So we got our student. We then loop through the enrollments, and then we print out the course title. And you can see how this is structured. So each enrollment can have a course and that title of that course. This all works because how we set up the structure for enrollment. So you can see enrollment can have a student and a course. So that is why entity framework, a lot of hard work for you behind the scene. That's why it's used quite a lot, because of ease of use with C# applications. So what could have been a very complex task has become a very simple task. We can just, with a few lines of code, are able to go deep down into a relationship within the database and pull out relevant records. So if I run this code over here, you can see that we've got enrollment here for John, and he's enrolled into English literature and computer science. This all has been done with a simple link query here. And we've used these two functions here to include the enrollment details and the course details. We're using bring back the first record. So if there's multiple Johns, then just bring back the first one. And then we just simply loop through that student. So that student information is stored in this variable. We just loop through it and show the output using console.writeLine.